In this question, we need to find the right limit, left limit, two-sided limit, and function values at x equals 2. Let us start by finding the left limit. Let us choose an x value on the left side of 2. As before, let us choose the furthest value under the graph on the left side of the 2, which is indicated by the red dot. To find the point on the graph corresponding to the x-coordinate in red, let's draw a vertical line from the red point to the graph, which is shown by the blue dot. To find the corresponding y-coordinate, let's draw a horizontal line from the blue point to the y-axis. Mark the point where the line meets the axis, with a green dot. The value of the y-coordinate is shown next to the green dot. Finally, the red dot shows the input x-coordinate, and the green dot shows the corresponding y-coordinate. Let's observe the movement of the y-coordinate as x moves towards 2 from the left. We can see that as x moves towards 2 from the left, y moves towards 1. Therefore, we conclude that the left limit of f at 2 is 1. We denote it by symbols as lim as x approaches 2 from the left of x equals 1. Let's now concentrate on the right limit. To find the right limit at 2, we have to approach 2 from the right side. Let's start from the furthest point under the graph on the right side, which is marked by the red dot. To find the point on the graph corresponding to the x-coordinate in red, let's draw a vertical line from the red point to the graph, which is shown by the blue dot. To find the corresponding y-coordinate, let's draw a horizontal line from the blue point to the y-axis. Mark the point where the line meets the axis, with a green dot. The value of the y-coordinate is shown next to the green dot. Finally, the red dot shows the input x-coordinate, and the green dot shows the corresponding y-coordinate. Let's observe the movement of the y-coordinate as x moves towards 2 from the right. We can see that as x moves towards 2 from the right, y moves towards 5. Therefore, we conclude that the right limit of f at 2 is 5. We denote it by symbols as x approaches 2 from the right, the limit of f of x equals 5. Let's now focus on the two-sided limit. We have already found the right limit and the left limit. By examining both limits, we can understand the function's behavior as x approaches 2 from both directions. If both sides are equal to the same value, then the two-sided limit is defined and equal to that value. However, in this case, the right limit at 2 is 1, and the left limit at 2 is 5. Since they are different, the two-sided limit is undefined. Finally, let's find the function value at x equals 2. To determine this, we need to locate the point on the graph that corresponds to x equals 2 on the x-axis. Let's first identify the point where x equals 2 on the x-axis, which is shown by the red dot. This will help us find the value of the function at this point. To find the value of the function at x equals 2, we need to draw a vertical line through the red dot at x equals 2. The y-coordinate of the point where the graph intersects the vertical line will give the function value at x equals 2. The graph appears to intersect the vertical line at two points, specifically at the open dot and the closed dot above the red point at x equals 2. However, according to conventions, the open dot does not belong to the graph and, therefore, does not count. The graph only intersects the vertical line at the closed dot, whose y-coordinate is 5. Therefore, the function value, f at x equals 2, is 5. Note that, in this case, the function value is defined, but the two-sided limit is not.